Hello, my name is Kyle Reed, and I work on the C++ Languages Services team for Visual Studio. I'm going to talk about three features of Visual Studio that can improve your productivity when working with C++. Two of the features are new in Visual Studio version 2022, and the third is an older and experimental feature that you may not have heard about. First, let's look at the IntelliSense Linter. This was an experimental feature in Visual Studio 2019, and in 2022, we've enabled it by default. This feature helps you find and fix common C++ problems while you're typing. It uses the IntelliSense engine, and problems are reported nearly as fast as you type. Results are displayed in the editor with underlines, as well as in the error list, so you can filter and navigate quickly. By default, messages are not shown in the error list, and you may need to enable them. Results are also shown on the side margin in the overview. And the file health indicator can navigate between errors and warnings. When the cursor is on a squiggle tag, you can see a short description of the error. And clicking on the light bulb or using the keyboard shortcut will open the list of suggested fixes. You can see a preview of the fix before the change is made. If you want to know more about an error, you can click on the code in the error list and it will take you to documentation about the warning. To configure the linter, open Tools, Options, Text Editor, C++, Code Style, Linter. Here you can enable the linter and change the severity of the checks. In order to prevent overlapping results with background code analysis, we hide redundant results, preferring the linter result instead, because the fixes are available and they're refreshed more quickly. So here's some examples of the supported checks. We saw this one already as part of the demo, but let's just show that again. You can see that this is a case where an assignment is being used instead of equality. So we can change that to either equality or inequality operator. And you can see that the warning disappears. Let's just look at a couple examples that are contrived just to show the point. In this first example, the check simply warns when a variable is declared but is uninitialized. Core guidelines recommend that variables are always initialized when they're declared. You can see that the check is aware of the type and provides an initializer that matches the type. This next check looks for cases when integers are assigned to a wider type after an arithmetic operation, in this case, the multiplication operation. It's possible that this sub-expression will overflow before it is assigned to the wider type, resulting in an overflow that is incorrect. The fix there is to cast this sub-expression to a wider type. Another example is the float truncation check, which looks for cases when integer division is being performed and then assigned to a floating point type. Most of the time, what you typically want is a floating point division to happen. So this is a suggestion, which is to cast one of the operands as a floating point type. The unintended copy check looks for cases when the use of auto may cause a copy that was not expected. In this case, if we wanted to enumerate the strings in the vector, auto string makes a copy each time. Likewise, when using the subscript operator, it may be the case that you didn't want to make a copy and just wanted a reference to it. We saw this one above. This checks for cases when, in a Boolean context, an assignment is made instead of comparison. This check looks for cases when bitwise operators are used with Boolean values and Boolean logic operators are used with integer values. And you can see that these checks run really quickly. So if we uncomment these, you can see how fast these checks are running. And in this case, we have a Boolean. And in this case, we expected the bitwise operator instead of the logical operator. The comparison precedent check looks for cases where bitwise operators are used in conjunction with comparison operators. The comparison operator has higher precedence, and so this part will be evaluated first. Using parentheses to set precedence is required. This next feature we've gotten a lot of requests for on developer community. It's called inline hints. Inline hints appear inline in the source code, but they're not part of it. Because they're shown without needing to hover over a symbol or invoke some kind of keyboard shortcut to show parameter help, they're really helpful when reading code, especially when the code is full of magic numbers. Inline hints are easy to toggle on and off, and so they're there when you need them, and they're out of your way when you don't need them. All you need to do is press Control twice to toggle hints across all instances of Visual Studio. When I'm using inline hints in my own code, I'll usually toggle it off while I'm actively writing, but then toggle it back on when reading or browsing. There are two flavors of inline hints, type hints and parameter hints. Type hints will show the actual type of a declaration that uses auto or decaltype auto. This is great when you're working in unfamiliar code with lots of autos. It can also help you spot errors in the actual return type is not what you expected. Finally, they can also help you spot errors in your code. For example, while we were testing, we found some game code where cosine x was being passed in for a parameter called sine theta. There are a few options that can be configured for inline hints. They are found under Tools, Options, Text Editor, C++, IntelliSense. Enable inline hints toggles the whole feature on and off. Display inline hints toggles whether they're shown in the UI. This can be toggled quickly using the keyboard shortcuts. Then we can decide to enable or disable type hints and parameter hints. Parameter hints can optionally show the ampersand indicating a non-const reference parameter. And we also can hide hints that have an argument if the argument text matches the parameter name. And the argument text can contain comments. Here's a function that shows inline hints very well. Double tap Control to bring them up, and we can see the type hints, fill position and fill length, that show the actual type. We can see that this function takes its parameter by non-const reference. Here we see the parameter names. There's also the option to hide hints which have the same name as the argument. So here's an example. Go to Tools, Options. You can hide hints when the argument text contains the parameter name. It also works if the comment contains the same name as the parameter name. So if your code has comments on magic numbers like this, then you won't show a hint. The final feature I want to talk about is Predictive Intellisense. This feature has been around for a while, but it's been hiding under the experimental page off by default. One of the difficulties of working with C and C++ is that there are just so many symbols in the global namespace. This can make looking for a name that you're not sure about challenging. Predictive IntelliSense can help with this by using type information to filter the suggestion list. For example, if you are assigning to a variable and we know its type, we'll try to only show completions with results with types that can be converted to the variable's type. In this case, we have a float. So we open the suggestion list, and we can see that the only results are things that could be assigned to a float. In this case, I have a function called getFloat, and you can see that just typing GE gets me getFloat. Likewise, for string, I can type getString, and there it is. The feature also looks at parameter types when suggesting completions for arguments. For example, I have a function called useFloat that takes a float. If I open the member list and look for suggestions, I can actually filter to locals and fields. There's the float. Same thing for string. Alt-V, and there's the string. If you want to see all results in the list, you can use Control-J to show the entire list. For example, use float. In this case, I want to use the object S. You can see it's not in the list, but if I hit Control-J, it'll show up, and now I can complete. If you want to try out Predictive IntelliSense, you can find it under Tools, Options, Text Editor, C++, Experimental, and check the Enable Predictive IntelliSense box. As always, we want your feedback. If there's something you love or something you don't love, please let us know on Developer Community. Your input helps us plan the future of Visual Studio.